feel a sense of uncertainty or spiritual disconnect, meet Pastor Richard Okadare, the senior pastor and founder of Christ Family Assembly Outreach, London. A father, husband, and pastor with a prophetic anointing, preaching the undiluted word of God worldwide for over 15 years. He is a teacher, author, and professional counselor, both therapeutic and spiritually, and is here to inspire your divine breakthrough. God continues to use Pastor Richard to encourage both young and old, male and female, and most especially couples. He is the editor-in-chief of the Awesome God magazine and your host of Awesome God. Listen here every Tuesday on PRZFM, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m., and be greatly blessed.
Hello, everyone. I welcome you to the Hour of Awesome God on PRZ Radio 109.2 FM. I am your host, Pastor Richard Okadare from Christ Family Assembly Outreach, London, UK. Thank you for tuning in. Tonight we are going to discuss about the topic, For Your Sake. For Your Sake. Shall we pray? Eternal Father, we bless and thank you because you're a good God. Thank you for this moment. Thank you for keeping us alive. Thank you because again we have the opportunity to discuss and talk about your word. And we agree together and pray that your word will bless us, your word will empower us, and your word will take us to the next level. At the end of the day, your name shall be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Welcome again to the Hour of Awesome God on PRZ Radio 109.2 FM. Turn with me to John chapter 11. The Gospel according to St. John chapter 11, and I read from verse 1. Now a certain man was sick named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary, and her sister Martha. It was that Mary which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with the hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore his sisters sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom you lovest is sick. He whom you love is sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. When he heard therefore that he was sick, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. Then after that said to his disciples, let us go unto Judea again. His disciples said unto him, Master, the Jews of late sought to stone thee, and you go there again? Jesus answered, are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbled not, but he see the light of the world, because he sees the light of the world. But if a man walk in the night, he stumbles, because there is no light in him. This thing said he, and after he had said unto them, our friend Lazarus sleeps, but I go that I may awake him out of sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. How be it? Jesus speak of his death, but the thought that he has spoken of taking of rest in sleep. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead. The last verse, I am glad for your sakes that I was not there, to the intent that you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go unto him. I am glad for your sakes. God is saying, the word of God is saying that he is glad for your sake. Number one, because he has created you in his own image. Out of over 1,000 and things that the Lord God has created, you are the only one he created in his own image. Isn't that a good thing to rejoice about? Glad for your sake. I am glad for your sake. So heaven is rejoicing over you. God is glad about you, regardless of what you are going through, regardless of your challenges or issues. God is aware and is glad because he wants to showcase you to the entire globe. He wants to package and brand what you are going through for the globe to see his power, for the globe to, for the entire globe to see his glory, for the entire globe that to see that he is the awesome God, he is a powerful God, able to do all things. This story tells us about Lazarus, a person that Jesus Christ loved, with his two sisters, Mary and Martha. And message was sent to Jesus Christ, your friend Lazarus is sick. If you hear the news that a friend or somebody or a family that you love is sick, there will be that eagerness to rush, to go over and to help or offer help or to provide or make provision. Something that will be a prompting that, yes, will trigger you to move towards that individual, wherever the person may be located. But this time around, Jesus Christ had the awareness that Lazarus was sick, instead of him to rush over, because that would be the intention of the sisters, that the moment Jesus Christ hears or heard or will hear about the issue of Lazarus, he will keep running. He will abandon or drop everything or whatsoever he is doing and keep running to come and help Lazarus that was sick. But this time, that was not the case. He deliberately stayed behind for some days. Verse 4, he said, when Jesus heard that this sickness is not unto them but to the glory of God, that the Son of God may be glorified. From verse 3, therefore the sister said unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom you love is sick. Look at that, the way that the Bible packaged and the word that was used, the person you love. How can a person you love be sick, be unwell, be unhappy, and you will not rush or run to meet that person and to offer help? But this time Jesus is not run or was not in a hurry to meet Lazarus. He heard of his sickness, and the Bible in verse 6 says he abode 2 days still in the same place. 2 days, not one day, but 2 days. He stayed 2 days where he was and allowed Lazarus that was sick to die. Lazarus did not just die, he was buried before Jesus Christ showed up. Before Jesus Christ appeared to the scene, when he heard that he was sick, if you hear that somebody that you love is sick, you will drop every other thing. In fact, if you need to obtain visa, you will obtain the visa quickly and pay any extra cost to fast track the journey. In the case of Jesus Christ, not so. And there was a dialogue between Jesus Christ and his disciples. From verse 11, this thing he said, that after he had said unto them, our friend Lazarus sleeps, but I go that I may awake him out of sleep. Be aware that Jesus Christ knew Lazarus was dead. And verse 12, the disciple said, Lord, if he sleep, that is very fine. And verse 13, further says, how be it? Jesus Christ spoke of his death, but they thought that he had spoken of taking of rest in sleep. Then Jesus Christ plainly tells the disciple Lazarus is dead. That's verse 14. So he knew, he was aware. And I've come to tell you as well, Jesus Christ is aware of what you are going through. And in fact, he is glad for those issues, for those challenges. Because thereby you will believe in him. Through what you are going through, your faith in Christ shall become strong. The toolkit to build your faith is that issue. The toolkit that will enable other people around you, friends, families, to believe in the living God is just your story, your success story, your testimony. Jesus Christ stayed back. He stayed back deliberately. Even when the disciples were still thinking, oh, perhaps Lazarus was asleep, he told them plainly, Lazarus is dead. And verse 15, that is the theme. He said, I am glad for your sakes that I was not there. Can you see that? Is there any underlying thing that you can pick? This is why Holy Spirit has given me this topic. I am glad for your sakes. Perhaps a person is so close to you and that person is somewhere. A person is so close to you and that person is in debt. In fact, they are about to repossess his properties. A person so close to you has just lost his or her job. A person so close to you has lost somebody he or she loved. And Jesus Christ is saying, I'm glad for your sake. Because that issue will build your faith in God. That issue, that those challenges will make your faith in God to become stronger. He said, I'm glad for your sakes. Even the disciples that were following Christ, Jesus Christ was ready to teach them certain things, the deep things of God that you and I do not know. He's ready to teach us through our own personal experience, through our own story. Others, we believe in God. We are very well aware and conscious that a lot of people will not even read their Bible. But your story will be spontaneous. Your story will touch them. And they will know that truly there is God who is awesome and able to do all things. Just like, I'm glad for your sake I was not there, to the intent that you may believe. Nevertheless, let us go to him. There is somebody that was dead and buried. In fact, when Martha met Jesus Christ, he said, by this time he stinks. If we look from verse 17, then when Jesus Christ came, he found that he had been laid in the grave 4 days already. Now Bethany was near unto Jerusalem, about 15 furlongs off. And many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brother that was dead. Then Martha, as soon as he heard that Jesus Christ was coming, went and met him. But Mary sat still in the house. Then Martha said unto Jesus, Lord, if you had been here earlier, my brother would not die. Look at that. I really admire the faith of Martha. She knew if Jesus Christ was there earlier, when they sent for Jesus Christ, if he had spontaneously responded to that invitation that yes, the friend whom you love is sick, Lazarus will not die. But Jesus Christ deliberately stayed behind so that Lazarus would die, not only die, but will be buried. I don't know perhaps what you are going through as well. And you are already tired. It seems there is no help. It seems there is no hope. Everything is turning hopeless. this hour, your hopelessness shall turn to hopefulness in the name of Jesus. All those things that seemed impossible, he says, I'm glad for your sake. Perhaps God is even glad that you are going through that. Jesus Christ is glad because you are the instrument, you are the vessel. Your story is what God is going to use to convert that brother, that sister, to believe in him. It's your story, your trying times, that will make people to embrace Christ, to embrace the word of God. It's your story, your success story, your joyful story, your joyful moments. That is what your neighbor is waiting for. That is what God is going to use. That is the toolkit that will build the faith of people around you. He's just waiting for you to go through it. You know, the Bible says, weeping may endure but for a night, joy cometh in the morning. This is the hour of your joy, because those issues will turn around. He's glad for your sake. He's glad for those issues. He's glad for those trouble and trying times. You will not die in it. Your story will not be like Lazarus that was dead and buried. But perhaps you have issues. You have very tough and trying periods that seemed unchangeable. The awesome God will step in this moment, this hour, and he will turn it around. He's glad that you are going through those things. He's glad for your sake, because the next minute, the next hour, the next day, the next week, you will become a celebrity. The moment your story changes, the moment things turn around, people will begin to run to you. People will begin to come to you. They want to hear, how did you do it? How did it happen? And you are just going to gladly tell them that yes, the awesome God has done it. Your sad story is going to turn to glad stories, joyful stories, joyful moments, things that makes you to go into perpetual low mood. God is going to step in and turn those things around for you in the name of Jesus. If he can do it for Lazarus, he can do it for you and I. And we are the next in the pipeline. You are just the next in the pipeline to encounter a wonderful turnaround in the name of Jesus. Yes, your story will be used for his glory. Your story will bring him praise. That is why he's glad for you. He's glad for those terrible things you are going through, because those terrible things will soon become those wonderful things. Those unpleasant situations, when you encounter the pleasant surprises of God, all the people in the community will come and celebrate you. You are the next in pipeline. Look at John 11 verse 4. When Jesus heard that Lazarus was sick, he said, the sickness is not unto death. Imagine. And people that were sent to him, by the time they go back, oh, we have told him, and he said, this sickness is not unto death. And lo and behold, they had the news, Lazarus was dead. And perhaps they are waiting. He will arrive. He will get to the scene before burial. But he deliberately delayed his coming. So he was buried. Oh, a mind-blowing miracle. That is what you will encounter. And the word of God will say, I am glad for your sake. I'm glad for your issue. I'm glad for those trying times. I'm glad for those terrible moments. After the head, there is light, a bright shining light. after that dark, after the dark tunnel, and that is what your issue is going to be. And you will hear, I'm glad for your story, I'm glad for your sake, I'm glad. God is waiting to brand that issue, to brand your story, to package it well, for people to know that truly is the awesome God, for people to be aware of his power, of his ability and capability, that is able to turn things around. And it's just your story that he will use. It's your issue. It's those challenges that God is going to use. Challenges need to come sometimes, so that we can build our faith, we can become strong in the Lord, so that we can boldly tell devil to his face that there is God, so that you can go on the street and boldly declare that there is God who is able to do all things. And people will question you, how did you know? Then you are able to tell your stories, that this is what he has done. And may your story turn lives around in the name of Jesus. May your story begin to make people to embrace Christ in the name of Jesus. And this tells me of what happened in John 9. There was a man that was born blind by his parents. John chapter 9 from verse 1. And Jesus passed by, and he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? And Jesus answered, neither has this man sinned nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. I must walk the works of him that sent him while it is day. Then I comment when no man can walk. As long as I am in the world, I am the light of the world. And when he had thus spoken, he spat unto the ground and made clay of spittle. And he anointed the eyes of the man with the clay and said unto him, go wash in the pool of Siloam, which by interpretation sent, and he went his way therefore and washed and came seeing. The neighbors therefore, and they which before had seen that he was blind, said, is not this man that sat and begged? Some said, this is he. Others said, it's like him. But he said, I am he. He said, I am he. I'm the one that was blind. Jesus Christ was glad for his sake that he can meet him along the way. Look at the question that the disciple asked him. Who sinned, this man or his parents? Perhaps people have been judging you too. People have concluded it's because of your sin. People have concluded because you are bad. People have judged you. People have caged you. They put you in a box. They say you're a bad person. They look at the story of your life, the story of your lineage. And they have concluded in their heart, they have assumed, but they didn't know, they didn't know, they never knew that yes, it is intended by God. That God will say, I'm glad for your sake, I'm glad for your issue, I'm glad for your challenges, because God just wants to showcase you. He wants to use you and showcase you to the entire globe that he is the awesome God. And people will be shocked. Your story will shock people, and it will be very amazing. Look at it. Some said this is he. Others said it's not him. He's just somebody like him. He can't be somebody that was born blind. How can he begin to see? How can he be walking around without no one leading him? And verse 10, the devil said unto him, how was your eyes opened? And the man said, a man that was called Jesus made clay, anointed my eyes, and said unto me, go to the pool of Siloam and wash. And I went and washed, and I received my sight. They said unto him, where is he? He said, I know not. Can you imagine? People will begin to look for ways to connect with your God because of your story. And God will declare, I'm glad for your sake. The country will begin to say, I'm glad for you. Heaven will rejoice because of your story. They will say, I'm glad for you. Your neighbors will say, I'm glad for you. Your family will say, I'm glad for you. Though they have ignored you earlier. Though they have neglected you before. Though you have been rejected. But they will come back and say, I'm glad for you. God is ready to showcase you. Don't give up. Don't give up. There's still hope. Hope of a better future. I've come to tell you that better days are ahead. Don't give up. Things will turn around. If God can do it, then he can do it again. And you are the next in line. In the name of Jesus, you are the next in line. Because I know he will use your story for his glory. You will soon encounter a major breakthrough that will announce you to the entire globe. That you will encounter a wonderful advancement in every facet of your life. You will begin to move from lack to abundance from this moment onwards. You are coming out of obscurity to the limelight in the name of Jesus. There is going to be a powerful translation from barrenness to fruitfulness. You that have been barren and people have been looking down on you. People have been saying you have no God. People have been talking about your sickness. People have been talking that yes, it's no longer possible. But when they see the tummy coming up, oh, some will say, oh, it's not real baby. And they will be amazed when you have your baby in the name of Jesus. Some will say it's virus. But when you come with your fine twins, they will be amazed in the name of Jesus. You will move and go from poverty to prosperity, from nothing to plenty. In the name of Jesus, you will rise from failure to success, and you're already successful. Your success story will continue in the name of Jesus. You will begin to break new grounds in the name of Jesus. The yoke of limitation upon your life shall be crushed and broken totally in the name of Jesus. You are crossing over all barriers, and so shall it be in Jesus' wonderful name. Yes, so shall it be. I'm glad for you. Thank you for listening. I'm done for the day, and till we meet next week Thursday, same time, stay tuned and stay connected. I am your host, Pastor Richard Opedari. If you have any prayer point or feedback, please, you can reach me on 07957-630187. I repeat, 07957-630187. If you live outside UK, please add +44, or you can email me on awesomegod@przfm.com. God bless you.
For over 15 years, he is a teacher, author, and professional counselor, both therapeutic and spiritually, and is here to inspire your divine breakthrough. God continues to use Pastor Richard to encourage both young and old, male and female, and most especially couples. He is the editor-in-chief of the Awesome God magazine and your host of Awesome God. Listen here every Tuesday on PRZFM, 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. and be greatly blessed.